Yes, our next chapter, that is your chemical calculation. As usual, that chemical calculation means different type of calculation we would like to do over here, beta. As usual, you know that no atoms are made or destroyed in chemical reactions. Means they also follow the conservation of atom. Only they would like to change their numbers. Okay. And we know that the relative atomic mass of each type of atom, that is with respect to mass of that atom. Okay. Or relative atomic mass, you can also understand that mass of any substance with respect to carbon mass, that is known as your relative atomic mass. Indirectly, you can understand that means, it doesn't matter of that one, means relative atomic mass, that means mass of substance upon mass of carbon, 12, okay? So approximately that would like to be same as, suppose that mass of oxygen, that is 16, so it would also be like that, relative atomic mass, that will also be equals to 16, okay? So basically, reacting mass calculation. Here the first topic, that is reacting mass calculation. As usual, we know that the mass of the reactant and product, that would like to be same with respect to conservation of mass. Okay. So simple ratio that we have to use to calculate reacting masses and product masses. Okay. So reactant mass. Here you are seeing a question, when 12 gram of carbon is burnt in air, 44 gram of carbon dioxide is produced. Okay. What mass of carbon is needed to produce 11 gram of carbon dioxide? You know that it is, yes, tell me. Let's check your answer. Your answer is right. Yeah, means here you can apply unitary method. Okay, here you can apply unitary method. I can, do you know about unitary method? Unitary or proportion method, beta? Proportion method. So also you can apply proportion method over there, just to understand that. So basically in proportion method, that you have to, did you apply proportion method over here, or do you think that I have to explain proportion method there? Oh, then that's great. So proportion method means on one side that you have to write that carbon which you have to require, and then other side that you have to write the amount of carbon dioxide. And then you can solve that one. Or also that here unitary method is also there. 12 gram of carbon, that makes 44 gram of carbon dioxide. So 1 gram of, so it will be 44 divided by 12. So then they are asking about that 11 gram. So in that condition, 11 multiplied by 12 divided by 44, that will give you 3 gram of carbon. Understand? So here is the best way to understand a reacting mass.